There's a few settings you can change in Photoshop that can remove frustration and save you a ton of time by eliminating repetitive tasks. So have a look at your current install, but also remember, whenever you update to a new version of Photoshop, you'll also need to redo these settings. So by default, when you close all your documents, it goes to this home screen. If you want to just stay in Photoshop and not have this home screen, let me show you how to do it. By the way, you can go into Photoshop by just simply clicking here. If we go under settings, under general, turn off auto show the home screen. Now when we open an image and we close it, it stays in Photoshop. Let's get better auto selections. So when you go to do an auto selection, we'll grab one of these magic tools, that's what I call them. Any of these will invoke the select subject. Now if you look by default, select subject says device. So we're going to choose select subject, Control J or Command J to copy it onto a new layer. Now if you want a better quality cutout, so what we need to do is change this to cloud. Choose select subject. And generally you get better selections. Of course it varies from image to image. But the thing is, whenever you grab this, it always defaults to device and you have to change it. Let's set it where it defaults to cloud and stays there. Let's go under Photoshop settings and we're going to choose image processing. At the very top, we have device. Let's change it to cloud. And now when we grab this by default, it's going to show cloud. Did you know that Photoshop comes with a bunch of extra assets? And the first time you set it up or when you update, you may lose these, but let's have a look. So if, for example, we look at the gradients, you can see there's a few sets here, but not a ton. But let's go under Window, Gradients, and we're going to open up the Gradients panel. If we look at this panel here, click this option, and then we're going to choose Legacy Gradients. Now, when we do, we get all these other sets. We get all the gradients that used to be in Photoshop, as well as other important things like photographic toning. This can only be done from the panel, can't be done from the gradient tool. And by the way, this is the same for patterns, legacy. It's also for swatches, color, shapes, and a lot of extras in Photoshop. And also if you want more extras, check out the free Photoshop vault that I have. I'll drop a link for that. While we're in here, if you remember, we used to have useful things at the very top of the gradients panel. Now you have to open these sets to find things. So let's open one of the groups and let's grab the foreground to background, foreground to transparent, and black to white. And if we drag these out of that set, so this means now that even when these are all collapsed, you have access to the most useful ones at the very top. They also appear now in the top of the gradients panel. You may also want to set this up for things like brushes, shapes, and other things that you might find useful. So sometimes when you want to find a previous document, you'll choose File, Open, Recent. But by default, it only shows the last 20 images. Let's expand that. So if we go under Settings, File Handling, let's change that to the maximum, which is 100. Click OK. Now when we choose File, Open, Recent, boom, all 100 are there. That's one of the first things I change when I update Photoshop. So really important time saver is setting up a custom workspace that you're going to use. This is the default workspace right now with the panels. But let's just go to something else. Let's pick something like, say, photography. So the reason I went to this, it has less tools. Let's get rid of the tools that we don't use very often. So I'm just going to close these out. Let's just drag them all out. Grab the properties, I'm going to drag that in there. And then we reset the toolbar, hit edit toolbar, restore defaults, and make sure everything's shown here. This is especially important when you upgrade to a new version of Photoshop. So this is also a big reason why people are missing tools when they update Photoshop, because the tool was added after they created the workspace. So go into your workspace, make sure you hit that default, get everything in there, click done. And then you're just going to choose Window Workspace. And then we're going to choose New Workspace. Column and Minimum. I want to make sure my menus, toolbars, and all that are set up. Then hit Save. Now, no matter what you do with your workspace, you just choose window, workspace, and then choose your new one that you created, reset, and everything will go back to how you set it. Or another thing, by the way, when you've got the taskbar, make sure you go here and pin that position so it doesn't jump around every time you choose a tool. Another one is color. So if we choose edit, and then we go down to the color settings. So there's a bunch of presets in here, but one of the things you may want to look at is your RGB space. A lot of the time I'll change this to Adobe RGB. So I'm curious how many of you use some of these same settings, and also what are your favorite settings? Let us know in the comments underneath. And by the way, save this, add it to a playlist, because you may want to come back to it, because whenever you update Photoshop, you're going to have to redo these settings. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.